Matrix with 6:21 left in the first.
Let's fast forward to the third period. The Black Bears down big, and they would score four in a row to make it a two-goal game. Tyson Kirkby netted his first with the Black Bears in game one with Binghamton. Then Tyler Jurich, Emil Strom, and Thomas Aldworth all scored. It was 7-5. And Danbury used that timeout early in the third period. You'll hear Coach Rod Davidson talk about that in just a little bit. But with the net empty, unfortunately, just couldn't get those two late goals to tie the game up and force overtime in the eventual loss. Black Bears Rewind presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Join the Booster Club. Just visit their table behind Section 4 at a Black Bears home game. We're going to take our first break. When we come back, you'll hear from Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson on the Endwell Rug pregame show from Binghamton on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
The Homer Men and Boys Store, a family-owned business providing clothing and footwear for the entire family since 1951. Located just 40 minutes north on Route 81 in the beautiful village of Homer, the Homer Men and Boys Store carries a huge inventory of name-brand products at like Carhartt, Red Wing, Carolina, Levi's, Columbia, North Face, Timberland, and many more. We carry all sizes from size 3 months up to 5X. We treat our customers like members of our family. If we don't have it, you don't need it. The Homer Men and Boys Store, located 40 miles north on Route 81. Take exit 12 and follow the signs to Homer, or see us on the web at homermensandboys.com.
When a hockey team ends up with six skaters and a goalie on the ice, it means somebody forgot to double check. And when you end up paying more for car insurance than you need to, it could also mean somebody forgot to double check. That's why State Farm will do a free discount double check by going through your policies to make sure you're getting all the discounts you deserve. Because those discounts could mean big league savings to double check. Call State Farm agent John Paulin in Johnson City today at 607-7191.
Check out a Binghamton Black Bears game like you've never seen before with a Skybox night or group night. You can even watch warm-ups from the Black Bears bench with your friends, high-five the players as they take the ice, and so much more. Or watch the game in style in a Skybox and check out a new and improved food and drink menu. Call the Black Bears at 607-722-7367 and begin your group or Skybox experience.
Now back to more of the Endwell Rug pregame show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena as the Zamboni has completed the resurfacing. Fans still starting to pour into the arena, and it is pouring outside as well. So hopefully everyone can stay a little bit dry if you're still on your way to the arena here for this 7 p.m. puck drop. You heard the highlights from last night's game, and now you'll hear from Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson.
Coach, you get another chance here tonight at Danbury at home, hoping for a different result. Again, last night, you fall behind and you mount a comeback in the third period, and you can kind of tell that they were a little nervous when you scored that first goal. They used their timeout.
Well, you know, we've just got to play a more complete game. We had such a terrific start last night. We had many chances. I think we missed two or three wide open nets. And then one of our defensemen steps up, makes a bad pinch, get caught on a 2-on-1. Next thing you know, we're fighting and we're down 1-0. And the game changes and the momentum swings. And got to get through to these guys. We got to stop doing that. We're, you know, making silly mistakes that really cost us. And then the floodgates opened up, and Danbury is a dangerous team and a very good team. And boy, we did make a comeback, but again, a little too late, a little too short.
I said in the first minute of that game, this was probably the best start that you had had against Danbury all season long, and it looked good. And like you said, just one play after all those great chances you had, and you found yourself down 1-0 and then eventually 3-0.
Yeah, and then when it got to 5-1, we finally started mounting up something. And we played a tremendous third period for sure and pulled the goalie a bit early, but thought, you know, two goals down, we need to get a couple. And it almost happened, but again, empty netter. And a couple penalties could have been called there in that crucial time, but they didn't cost the game.
Yeah, I was talking about those calls there at the end of the broadcast, and a little frustration boiled over after that non-high stick call.
Yeah, it's too bad. You know, the referees have a difficult job. They have the toughest job in the building. They explained it to me afterwards. They thought it was just kind of coincidental contact. We saw it different, but you know what? It wasn't the direct result of the game. We could have used a moment would have helped us stay in the game, but not their fault.
Said that as well at the end. Just, you know, it didn't decide the outcome of the game. Just caused a little bit more frustration on the end of the losing side of it. Fast forward here to tonight. No Joe Shepherd. He got injured in the game last night. Do you have any type of status?
His shoulder was bothering him. He got a nice treatment after the game last night, and it's day-to-day, I'd say. Chris Marcello came in as an emergency backup, so we're going with Owen again. And, you know, we need the team to just show up and perform tonight. We just can't continue to lose to Danbury, even though they're a very good team.
Guys back in the lineup last night, including some new faces, Tyson Kirkby, he had a very nice goal, and I thought Danny Vanderweel back in his first game since that punch from Alex Basie. He had a great scoring chance in that game, just a good glove save.
Yeah, Vandy gave us a lot of energy. Kirkby, you can see the experience that he gained playing up in the Southern Pro League. He's been a nice addition. Sam Turner came back from the Southern Pro League. He'll be a strong addition. So more new bodies, more new faces. And it should be a good evening tonight.
And more decisions for the head coach.
A little tougher, but that's why we get paid the big bucks, right?
There you go. Coach, thanks. Have fun here tonight at home.
Thanks, Rob.
That is Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson. We'll take a break here on the Endwell Rug pregame show. Back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
Hi, folks. Irwin Coe Sr. here from Big E Tire. It's our buy three, get one absolutely free sale. Oh, I know what you're saying. Wow, another tire sale. No, there's more. Listen, now when you buy three tires from Big E, you will get one tire absolutely free with free mounting, free lifetime balancing, free rotations, free 90-day road hazard warranty, free alignment check, free 30-day ride guarantee. Yeah, it's good. Because the other guys charge you for everything. At Big E, everything is free. Interest-free financing for up to 12 months and the fastest error-free alignments in the Northeast. So call for details or just stop in. And thanks for the business.
For cars and trucks and tractors too, everything's quite so right for you. Best all around our Big E Tire and Auto Centers.
Big E Tire, I love those guys.
Hard-hitting action of Black Bears hockey returns Friday, April 1st and Saturday, April 2nd against Columbus at 7 p.m. Friday is College Rush Night. All college students get $5 tickets. Then Saturday is the Police versus Fire Hart Cup game for just $15. Watch Police versus Fire at 3:30 and stay for the Black Bears game at 7. $5 from every ticket will benefit the American Heart Association. For tickets, visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Now back to more of the Endwell Rug pregame show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside of Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. You just heard from Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson as he's pumped up here to get back in action on home ice before the Black Bears are going to hit the road. They'll be in Delaware tomorrow afternoon, and then it's off to Carolina for three straight next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Let's take a look at tonight's scratches and injury update presented by the Court Jester Athletic Club. We'll start with Danbury out of the lineup here tonight. Garrett Gallagher He had a goal against Binghamton last Friday night on the road in Danbury. Out tonight, Easton Oliver out of the lineup. Gordy Bunnell is out. Tom and Steve Mealy out of the lineup. Dustin Gesso, Adam Dauda, Nikolai Lavac, Aaron Atwell injured still, and Tobias Ogic will miss tonight's game. And the third goaltender out of the lineup is Frankie McClendon. For Binghamton, Tom Tracy out tonight along with defenseman Maverick Wines, who made his debut last night. Brandon Contrado out of the lineup along with Corey Sherman, Cam Yarwood, Eric Oganazov, and then Mo Lavac still injured. He will be out tonight. Joe Shepard will not be dressing tonight, as you heard coach say he was run into last night, left the game. And it'll be Chris Marcillo, who was with the Black Bears to start the season. He will be the backup tonight as Owen Liskowitz will get the start. That is a look at the scratches and injury update presented by the Corchester Athletic Club, Binghamton's premier fitness facility. Now it's time for the starting lineup for the Black Bears, presented by Visions Federal Credit Union. On defense, Colin Fitzgerald paired up with Kyle Powell, and up front is Tyler Jurich with Gino D'Angelo and Tyson Kirkby. That is a look at the starting lineup. And of course, in net, as we mentioned, is number 72, Owen Liskowitz. That is a look at tonight's starting lineup presented by Visions Federal Credit Union. Are you a member? Then you get discount Black Bears tickets. Head online to visionsfcu.org/events. Two other games going on in the FPHL tonight. Port Huron is in Carolina in the third game of the night. Watertown is in Columbus. That is a look at the out-of-town scores brought to you by John Paulin State Farm. Visit them online at paulininsurance.com or call 607-798-7191. That's going to do it for tonight's edition of the Endwell Rug pregame show. Endwell Rug, the best floor show in town. When we come back, we'll have the EBE CMS Imaging Solutions opening face-off. Black Bears and Danbury coming up next on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Tonight's game performed on Fox Sports by Seton Catholic High School senior Annika Christensen.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, set to go here on a rainy Saturday night. Binghamton hoping to get back into the win column as they look to end a little skid at the hands of the Danbury Hattricks. Binghamton in their specialty St. Patrick's Day themed jerseys. They will go from right to left. Danbury, the Road Whites, they're going to go from left to right. Tonight's opening faceoff is brought to you by EBE CMS Imaging Solutions, the official printer provider of the Binghamton Black Bears. Good crowd on hand here tonight in Binghamton, probably expecting around 3,000. As the home games remaining, that number keeps getting smaller and smaller before Binghamton will get a crack at the Commissioner's Cup playoff. But who will they play in the first round? Gino D'Angelo will take the face-off against Johnny Ruiz. Both goaltenders tapping the post. They give the head nods. And here we go. Puck is down. Ruiz wins it all the way back down the ice. Steve Brown back in the lineup after the suspension for leaving the bench here in Binghamton last weekend. But he is back in the lineup. Tyler Jurich back to Kyle Powell. Up to center ice. Gino D'Angelo takes over. Quick snapshot taken on net. And that one sails wide. That was Tyson Kirkby with the opportunity. Kyle Powell steps up. Powell down low to Jurich. Jurich looking. Looks to feather in front of the net for Powell. And they're going to say that the puck went up and deflected into the netting. So that means no delay of game. And our first whistle comes 43 seconds into the game. Tonight's first period is brought to you by Cost Cutters. Whatever your style, they've got it. Schedule your next appointment at costcutters.com. Back to Nikita Ivashkin. Rising wrister misses the net. MJ Merkel tried to keep the puck inside the zone, did, but had to back up out to center ice. Dmitry Daniluk up the right boards, out of the reach of Vinny Susi. And now Nikita Ivashkin over to Merkel. Off the glass, gloved out of the air by Kodiak White Duck. Merkel steps up on him. That jars the puck free, and then the pass out to center ice is tipped by White Duck. So Danbury will regain possession and dump the puck in. 18:43 left to go in the first period. No score. Black Bears and hat tricks here from Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Rob Lapolis with you. Hope you're having a good weekend. On the breakout pass, connecting at center. Brett Jackson, offensive zone. Jackson trying to connect with Mike Lopez. Puck comes up to the point for John Stefanson. Gets by him. And Danbury will regroup. Pass out to center, goes off the stick of Adamo Asselin, and that'll be an icing. And Binghamton will get an offensive zone faceoff with 18 minutes and 11 seconds to go in period one. Still no score. Black Bears will be holding a in-arena jersey auction following this game over in section four. And if you want to get your hands on a St. Patrick's Day themed jersey, you'll have a chance immediately following this game. Got a lot coming up for the Black Bears here on home ice. A jam-packed end of the regular season. And we'll get to that in just a little bit. 18:07 left in the first. Offensive zone faceoff for Binghamton. In the right wing circle, Thomas Aldworth moves the puck ahead. Aldworth out front for Danny Vanderweel. The puck just hopped over his blade. Tal Finberg moves in for Danbury. Wheels the puck in, rolls it around the corner to the near side of the ice. Vanderweel jars it free. Yates intercepts on the center ice line. Gavin Yates will backhand the puck below the goal line. One forechecker, that's Yates, lays a hit on Zachary Lazaro. And the Black Bears defenseman, Mathieu Boisdar, will lift to center, but has to chase back as the puck was turned over right away. Boisdar to Pekarski. Pekarski onto the stick of Aldworth. He overskated it. Kuznetsov fires it in. Corey Anderson couldn't hold the puck inside the zone, and then that went off a Black Bear on the bench, and play stops with 17:17 left in period one. Now the Black Bear is back home April 1st. That's a Friday, college student night, $5 college student tickets. You can get those right now at BinghamtonBlackBears.com. And that is a three-game weekend. We'll get to the other two games coming up here in a little bit. Corey Anderson deflects the puck in on net, and Owen Liskowitz will cover up. Then Saturday, April 2nd, the Hart Cup game. That's the Binghamton Police Department and Binghamton Fire Department. They're going to go at it at 3:30, and then you can stay for the Black Bears game at 7. Tickets are just $15 for that, and $5 from the tickets sold through the Heart Cup link are going to the American Heart Association. So come on out for that. You can get that link right now as well at binghamtonblackbears.com. Icing waved off, and Danbury forced to break out from left to right. Right inside the neutral zone. Ahead to Gino D'Angelo. D'Angelo, top of the right wing circle, lost the puck. And back through center is Kodiak, White Duck. White Duck and MJ Merkel. Merkel pushes him right out of the zone, pushes the puck out as well. 16:20 remaining in the first, scoreless. Down the left wing side, snapshot is tipped wide. Mike Lopez with the opportunity. Asselin along the right wing boards, backhanded towards the front of the net by Brett Jackson, and it's picked off by Sam Turner, the defenseman. Turner off the skates of Dmitry Daniluk, comes over to the near wall. Mike Lopez ahead to Brett Jackson. Jackson over the blue line into the offensive zone, feathers it to Daniluk, who shoots a wrister into the glove of Liskowitz, and a whistle with 15:49 remaining in period one. Shots right now 1-0. Not sure if that's his second shot or not. I thought it was. With Binghamton yet to record a shot almost 5 minutes into the game. On the draw in the D zone, Piekarski cleared it over the wall. That goes off a skate, and the puck is going to one hop off the Zamboni door. Piekarski lost it to Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz gave the puck to Mathieu Boilard at the top of the crease. Here comes Boilard over the blue line. Offensive zone, fighting through the pressure. Boilard centers, puck comes up. Piekarski, a shot blocked by Tal Finberg. Downloaded, Nikita Ivashkin. Backhands into the right wing circle. Glove down, Piekarski again. Side of the net for Ivashkin. Nikita Ivashkin changes direction, and then Newberg sends the puck through the top of the crease. Taken by Kuznetsov. He hustles ahead with Tal Finberg. Kuznetsov fans on the wrister and then just plays the puck in down low. Wraps up to the near side. Emil Strome with it. Strome to Newberg. Newberg to Ivashkin. And he tried to cut up the ice fast. Corey Anderson stops. And now Piekarski will take over to Danny Vanderweel. Vanderweel turns back in behind the net. Moves out to center for Gavin Yates. Yates well offside, and a whistle with 14:33 remaining in period number one. We'll take our first time out. Binghamton, Danbury, no score. We'll be back right after this inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena on your home for Black Bears hockey. Fox Sports 14:30 Binghamton. Center is where Binghamton hockey fans bowl with open bowling all week, along with money-saving specials. Ideal is a great place for family, friends, company parties, and special occasions. Ideal Bowling Center, 119 Jennings Street, Endicott. There's so much more than just your favorite bowling alley. 14:32 remaining in the first period. No score in Binghamton. Rob Lopolis with you here on a Saturday. Be with you tomorrow on a Sunday as well on the road in Delaware. Gavin Yates behind the net to Danny Vanderweel. He ran into the boards. That allows Corey Anderson to feed the puck ahead to Kodiak White Duck. And then Phil Bronner dumps it in right on net. Stopped by Liskowitz. A 14 minutes and 9 seconds now to go in the first period. And at the other end of the ice, Peter DeSalvo has not faced a shot yet. Centered, save made by Liskowitz. Puck rolls in down low below the goal line outside the trapezoid. Thomas Aldworth flies ahead through center. Aldworth to Yates. Yates, toe drag in front. Right leg pad, save made. Oh, and then, boy, Brown is just swinging away at Aldworth. What on earth happened? Steve Brown, fresh off a suspension, goes after Aldworth. The puck was coming out the other way. Did not see how that started. Just saw the end of it. But my goodness, Brown is livid at Aldworth. And not sure if that carried over from last night. Brown wasn't in the lineup last night. As we're getting a look right now on the video board, Aldworth was up against the back of the net. Wow. So Aldworth, not going to get a penalty for that, as Brown, you know, it was tough to see how that even developed, but only a 2-minute penalty for Brown, and the Black Bears are going to go on the Big E Tire power play, and Brown having a conversation with the official. So, Big E Tire power play for Binghamton. I mean, there were punches thrown. So, just a 2-minute penalty to Brown. And the Black Bears again on the Big E Tire power play. Big E Tire, nobody beats their prices. Nobody.
Brown, 2 minutes roughing. Time of the penalty, 6:10. It's Brown, 2 minutes roughing. Time of the penalty, 6:10.
Out to the right point for Kyle Powell. 2 feet inside the blue line. He goes to the right side. Snapshot, taken, save made. Blast from Ivashkin. Misses the net. Powell fires one right on target. And a chest save made by DeSalvo, and a whistle with 1:34 to go in the Brown roughing penalty, and 13:23 remaining in period number one. So the faceoff now inside the offensive zone, left wing circle. Yates, Aldworth, Kirkby, Powell, and Jurich. Jurich over to Powell, working the center point. Now to Jurich. Jurich shooting straight up in the air. Yates tries to jam it in on the near side. Couldn't do so, and then Danbury will clear. Powell back to pick up the puck. Left to him from Owen Liskowitz. Powell skates up in front of the crease. Leaves it now for Gavin Yates. Yates into the offensive zone. Will wrap the puck up. Jurich has to hustle to get over there. Could not in time. And Bronner clears with under a minute to go in the Big E Tire power play for Binghamton. 12:40 left to go in the first. No score. Shots now 3-2 Black Bears. Saucer pass by Jurich. Out of the reach of Powell. Cleared to the far blue line. Jurich turns right back to Kirkby. Kirkby off the boards to Gavin Yates. Yates to Kirkby. Couldn't get through the pressure. And cleared by White Duck. 12:17 to go in the first. No score. The speed from Ivashkin through center. One on two, Ivashkin lets a wrister go, tipped wide of the net, and then he lost an edge. Jam play, top of the crease, covered by DeSalvo. And a whistle with 12:02 left to go in the first period, and 13 seconds left in the penalty to Brown. Face-off, offensive zone, left wing circle for the Black Bears. In a nice crowd here. Side's pretty full. Johnny Ruiz is in, shorthanded. Ruiz behind the net, trying to bank the puck in off Liskowitz. Still has it below the goal line, and the Black Bears can't get possession. The penalty is over. Good kill by Danbury here on the road. 11:37 left in the first, scoreless. Fans trying to get behind the Black Bears. Skating into the offensive zone, Emil Strom. Down to Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashkin, right wing circle, still has it. Now to the point for Mathieu Boilard. His shot is deflected up and out of play with 11:18 to go in period one. Binghamton will make a line change. Kirkby, Jurich, and D'Angelo, Merkel, and Sam Turner up top. This is Sam Turner's first home game of the season. He started the year with Binghamton, played two games in Watertown, and then went off to the SPHL, and he is back, played last night. And his first home game. MJ Merkel back, tries to get the puck out of the zone. Stefancic holds it in for Danbury. Good little move by Turner. Turner on the breakout, tap by Kirkby to D'Angelo. D'Angelo in, looking back door for Jurich, wasn't quite there. Corey Anderson collides with Kirkby, lost his stick. Kirkby, one jam play, another one. Puck still free, and it's covered up and held on to for a whistle by DeSalvo. At 10:36 left to go in period number one. Both sides will make more personnel changes. And the faceoff will be in the offensive zone, left wing circle. Good move by D'Angelo, just sent the puck right through the top of the crease, hoping someone was there. Danny Vanderweel will take the faceoff. Aldworth to his left, and Yates to the right. On the breakout, up the left wing side, it's Adamo Asselin. Down low, behind the net, to Mike Lopez. And now, Aldworth. Down the right side. Thomas Aldworth through the top of the crease, wanted Yates. Fitzgerald lets one go, that hits Aldworth. And he'll fire the puck in on net. Inside the blue line, Gavin Yates has it. Steve Brown is on him. Yates drops it. Aldworth has space. He's got room. Aldworth trying to get the shot away, but it was blocked. Good stick at the last second. Powell, ankle-high saucer to Colin Fitzgerald, but the puck rolled through his legs, and now Danbury comes back out. Asselin. Cross ice pass, Gavin Yates will skate towards the goal line, and that'll buy him some time with Kuznetsov waiting. Up the right boards, 9:34 remaining in the first period, delayed offside, so Newberg, Ivashkin, they have the U-turn back out to center. The delayed offside is over. Kuznetsov has the puck with Ruiz. Kuznetsov, Ruiz, wrister saved by Liskowitz with 9:19 remaining in period one. We will take a break. Still no score between Danbury and Binghamton. We're back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Binghamton, get ready for WWE Sunday Star, April 24th at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. See Roman Reigns defend the Universal Championship against Drew McIntyre.
I am going to make your life hard.
In a triple threat match for the SmackDown Tag Team Championships, the New Day and Sheamus and Ridge Holland challenge the Usos. Plus, SmackDown Women's Champion Charlotte Flair and more. Tickets start at $15. Available now at the box office and Ticketmaster.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Rob Lopolis with you. No score between Binghamton and Danbury. College students, don't forget, every Saturday you can get a $10 ticket and then take that ticket stub over to Dillinger's after the game for a buy one, get one free drink. So that's college students, $10 tickets every Saturday and a buy one, get one beverage at Dillinger's after the game. Also next, or two Sundays from now, April 3rd, college students get $5 tickets. It's a college rush night for that Sunday, or that Friday game, I should say. So Friday, April 1st against Columbus. That's a busy weekend, three straight home games for the Black Bears. Matthew Wallar up to Emil Strom, taken by Johnny Ruiz, and he gets a rough ride from Josh Newberg. Now Ruiz gets around Newberg and looks for Tal Finberg. What a move by Ruiz. Finberg unable to pull the trigger. Blocked. Pass. Onside. Hooked. Do we have a penalty shot? No. Just a slash. A slashing call to Dmitry Daniluk, and the fans, I thought they might give a penalty shot on that. That's what Josh Newberg is arguing about down low. They might say that Ivoshkin didn't have a clear enough breakaway. And the faceoff will be inside the offensive zone. What a pass, though. That looked like a pretty clear breakaway. Henry West, save. And then Aldworth gets into it with Brown again. And Brown swinging away. And then Aldworth lands on top of him. Boy, Steve Brown is just irate with Aldworth. That's their second altercation of the first period. To talk to Brown. And the crowd not happy. So you had Corey Anderson holding Aldworth and then Brown throwing shots. Aldworth broke free, landed on top, and then they wrestled around a bit. And wait, linesmen were trying to hold Brown back, and it looks like, is Aldworth not going to get anything on this again? This could be the second straight time in the first period that Steve Brown ends up in the penalty box and Thomas Aldworth does not. Discussion going on down low. And Brown is gone. So Steve Brown shown to the locker room. And I wonder what the call is. Wow, watching that replay. And Aldworth just wrapped him up. And once they got down, it took both linesmen to pull Brown off of Aldworth. Thank you. in another lengthy first period delay. Johnny Ruiz, Corey Anderson there. Ruiz not happy. Now I think Allworth should be in the box. I mean, and Allworth's gonna head to lock. I don't know if he was thrown out. I don't see why he would have been. I also don't really see why Steve Brown would have been thrown out. They gotta wait for the calls though. So Allworth, 2 minutes for roughing, or 2 minute minor penalty. We'll just throw that out. And someone has come over to serve a penalty for Danbury. Here we go.
44, Steve Brown. 5 minutes for fighting. And a game misconduct. Binghamton penalty to number 19, Thomas Allworth. 2 minutes for slashing, time of the penalty, 11:17. Being served by number 6, Gavin Abbott. That's Brown, 5 for fighting and a game misconduct. And Allworth, 2 minutes for slashing, time of the penalties, 11:17.
Well, there you go. So 5 for fighting and a game misconduct. And it's a 4-on-3 power play for Binghamton for a minute and 52 seconds. This crowd is into it early on. Kyle Powell sets up. He's got Jurich to the right. Powell, Strom, oh my goodness, off the inside of the post, and it stays out. You gotta be kidding. Here comes Ruiz the other way, and a glove save by Liskowitz. What action early on. Face off in the defensive zone, left circle. Oh, watching the replay. Poor Strome, he's gonna see that one in his sleep. It was hard to tell if DeSalvo got just a piece of it, or did that go off the inside of the post and right along the goal line. Kirkby, backhand, he scores! Tyson Kirkby! Strikes first with 8:03 left in the first. Dicing, Kirkby, what a goal.
Scored by number 18, Tyson Kirkby. Assisted by number 22, Tyler Jurich, and by number 27, Kyle Powell. Time of the goal, 11:57.
There you have it. Powell works back into his own end. So 4-on-4. That goal ended the power play. And in 51 seconds, Binghamton will get a 3-minute power play on that major by Steve Brown. Faceoff will be in the neutral zone. Binghamton went offside. Dropped the puck on the far side of the ice. Back to Colin Fitzgerald. Now down the right boards. In, Ivashkin through the top of the crease. Puck rolled off the end of his stick. Another chance, Powell, right circle, Wade shoots, tipped wide, and the puck went in down low below the goal line. Back up center point for Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashki slams the brakes on. Back to Colin Fitzgerald. His cross ice pass tipped by Ruiz. Back to Fitzgerald, over to Powell. That shot deflects up. Right at center, Stefanson looking around for help, but Danbury was in a line change. Colin Fitzgerald shoulders him off the puck, and now ahead is Ivashkin. Ivashkin will go across the top of the circles, loses the puck, but kept in by MJ Merkel. Merkel gives it up, and Lopez will clear. 2:35 to go in the Steve Brown major penalty. Binghamton a 1-0 lead with 6:10 left to go in the first. Left side, Rister, and a save made. Kirkby was looking for another just inside the blue line. That hit the linesman and actually turned into a delayed offside. That'll give Danbury some time to clear. They do. 2 minutes now left to go in the Big E Tire power play. Yates into the offensive zone, slows it down. Now to the high slot for Strom. Jurich back to Yates. Yates to Sam Turner. Turner, heavy pressure, gets rid of the puck quickly to Yates. Down low now to Tyson Kirkby. Kirkby up top, and now Yates has to hustle. He's got Corey Anderson on him. Yates with 1:32 to go in the power play. Up for Strom, back to Strom in front, backhand save by DeSalvo. Strom, second A-plus chance, as Liskowitz will glove the puck down on the clear. A minute 13 to go. Good give and go by Yates and Strom. Off the boards to Gavin Yates. Now Ivashkin usually tries to get some, a lot of speed. Has some. Over the blue line. He's got Vanderweel. Missing the net was Ivashkin. Off the boards and down to Powell. 50 to go with the Big E Tire power play. Saucer by Powell to Vanderweel. Vanderweel down the right wing side. Trying to get around the defense. Vanderweel! Collision, top of the crease. Yates lost the puck. They can't clear, and now an injury on the play. Who is that down to our left? As a trainer will come out onto the ice. We'll take a quick break. 4:19 left to go in the first. Binghamton a 1-0 lead. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
4:19 left to go in the first period. Binghamton a 1-0 lead. Are you interested in providing care to people with disabilities? Check out a New York State career with Broom OPWDD. Job security, health insurance, retirement plans, paid time off, and more. Positions such as direct support professionals in the community might be exactly the change of pace you're looking for. For more information, call 607-240-4786 or go online opwdd.ny.club.gov and click apply. Got to get that read down a little bit better. Unable to get the puck out of the zone down the ice. Newberg shaken up a bit. He's going to stay out there, though, waiting on the far blue line with under 20 seconds to go in the power play. And Corey Anderson, boy, the puck went off his skate and right in on net. That forced Liskowitz to make a save. giveaway. Anderson, save made. He was wide open in front of the net. And Liskowitz was there. 4 seconds to go in the 5-minute major power play. 3:47 to go in period one. The Black Bears with a 1-0 lead. Ace off in the defensive zone. Right wing circle. That player that was injured was McDonald. John McDonald usually wears number 8, but he has number 10 on here in this road game. We apologize as he skated off slowly, and we'll keep an eye on him. 3:25 to go in the first. Binghamton, a 1-0 lead. Gino D'Angelo holds the puck inside the zone. Kirkby lets Powell take it. Powell shooting, save made. DeSalvo, puck still loose behind the net. Now free. Phil Bronner will lift it all the way down the ice. Perfectly played by Bronner. Pekarski has to play the puck a couple of feet from the goal line. Juric has it in his skates. Tyler Juric, cross ice, Matthew Wallar. Wallar, low shot, stick save to Salvo. Puck went off the top of the glass, stays in though. Cross ice pass, Vinny Susi intercepts, ahead to Tal Finberg, back to Johnny Ruiz, back to Finberg, out front for Kuznetsov, off a skate before it got to him. Now to Kuznetsov, above the hash marks. His shot stays on the ice, misses the net. Tal Finberg fires from the left circle, patted away by Liskowitz. Now Tyson Kirkby along the left boards, knocked out of the air by Adamo Asselin, and that was a delayed high stick touched by the Black Bears, so that went away. Clear by DeSalvo, Gino D'Angelo was right there. Sam Turner to MJ Merkel for Gavin Abbott. Abbott at center ice, has the puck in his skates, moves ahead, Abbott, saucer, Vanderweel! Lost his stick and the puck went just wide. Good pass, and Danny Vanderweel's all over the ice here to start this one. Vanderweel now to Turner. Sam Turner, right circle, good move, Turner! A skate saved by DeSalvo. Back to Yates in front. Abbott, save. Puck straight up in the air and it lands on the ice. They're going to say it went in the netting. It was hard to tell if it did, but the puck was up in the air for so long. I don't blame them for blowing the whistle. 1:22 to go in period one. Stay with us after the first period comes to an end. We'll have the Excite Motorsports first period intermission report. Full recap of the first 20. Booster Club highlights and a look at the John Paulin State Farm out of town scoreboard. We'll hang out here after the period comes to an end. We'll recap everything and get you set for period two. A minute 13 to go in the first. 1-0 Binghamton. Up for Emil Strom. He could easily have two goals in this first period. Ivashkin, bottom of the right wing circle. Nikita Ivashkin holds, has the puck onto his stick. Lost it. Bronner will once again lift up and glove down. It gets through the legs of Powell. He's got a hustle. Kodiak White Duck is there. White Duck takes the puck. Powell went to lift the stick. White Duck down low for Corey Anderson. Anderson spins away from Colin Fitzgerald, who stays right with him along the boards. Cycled down low by Anderson. Newberg in a battle with White Duck. There's a couple of number 14s going at it. Kuznetsov, snapshot, shoulder save, Liskowitz. And Powell scurries in behind his own net to get some time. Powell holds on to the puck, 7 seconds to go in the first. And he will burn the rest of this time off. Newberg back to Powell. That is it for 20 minutes of play here inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Well, sparks were flying early on here in this one. between the Black Bears and the Hat Tricks. But after everything started to settle down a little bit, a back and forth game. And after 20 minutes of play, it is the Binghamton Black Bears with a 1-0 lead over Danbury. We will take a timeout. When we come back, though, we'll kick off the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show. Binghamton a 1-0 lead after one period of play. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Be the first to get all the latest Binghamton Black Bears news, special exclusive offers, and stay up to date on upcoming games by signing up to join the Binghamton Black Bears email club. Just head to binghamtonblackbears.com and sign up today. You'll receive team-related news delivered right to your inbox. Keep an eye out for special exclusive offers only available to email club members. It's the Binghamton Black Bears email club. Sign up and start saving money today.
You could save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive, yes. But when we just come out and say it, it yes, feels God, like dog. It falls a bit flat. So instead, we're going to hire a professional voice actor and pay him absurd amounts of money to say,
I like this product.
Not sure why that was better. I mean, I'm a professional too, but we didn't pay him to say the business part, so back to me. Save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive. Sorry, I know hearing me say it was a bit of a letdown. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Discount not available in all states or situations.
The Binghamton Black Bears are hitting the ice this season at Visions Federal Credit Union, Veterans Memorial Arena, and we want you to see all the hard-hitting action of Black Bears hockey all season long. That's why Visions members can get discounted tickets to every home game this season. It's one of the many reasons to join the Visions family today. To get your member discount and see the Black Bears in action, visit visionsfcu.org/events. Visions Federal Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA.
Hard-hitting action of Black Bears hockey returns Friday, April 1st and Saturday, April 2nd against Columbus at 7 p.m. Friday is College Rush Night. All college students get $5 tickets. Then Saturday is the Police versus Fire Heart Cup game for just $15. Watch Police versus Fire at 3:30 and stay for the Black Bears game at 7. $5 from every ticket will benefit the American Heart Association. For tickets, visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Binghamton, get ready for WWE's Sunday Stunner. April 24th at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena.
Acknowledge me.
See Roman Reigns defend the Universal Championship against Drew McIntyre.
I am going to make your life hell.
In a triple threat match for the SmackDown Tag Team Championships, The New Day and Sheamus and Ridge Holland challenge the Usos.
Hear that, Us?
Plus, SmackDown Women's Champion Charlotte Flair and more. Tickets start at $15. Available now at the box office and Ticketmaster.
The first period is in the books. It's time for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report, a recap of the first period, interviews, highlights, out-of-town scores, and more. Planet Fitness Broadcast Booth for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Here's Rob Lapolis.
20 minutes gone here inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. It is time for the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show. Excite Motorsports, browse, ride, buy. Free next day delivery to New York and PA. Visit them online at excitemotorsports.com. Well, let's take a look at the first period summary. As things got pretty physical early on in the game, Steve Brown behind the net, again, did not see if anything had happened prior to that, but when I saw behind the net, Aldworth was pushed up against the back of the net. Steve Brown was giving him the business. And they went down to the ice, small crowd gathered. Brown got the only penalty from that. It was a roughing minor at 6:10. Then some slashing penalties as Dmitry Kuznetsov went off for slashing at 11:09. That was on the partial breakaway for Nikita Ivashkin. Thought they might award a penalty shot, but they just gave a slash, and Binghamton went on the Big E Tire power play. Then at 11:17, Aldworth and Brown again, this time Brown was assessed a five-minute major for fighting and a game misconduct aggressor penalty. Aldworth picked up two for slashing as they got into it in front of the net, but Brown shown the gate. Aldworth went off the ice, and we'll see if he needed any repairs or whatnot, maybe to the helmet. Wasn't sure if it was equipment or what, but he exited the ice, and we'll keep an eye on that when period two begins. So that is it for the penalties in period one. Danbury, four penalties for 19 minutes. Binghamton, Aldworth, one penalty for 2 minutes. The only goal of the game, power play goal at 11:57, courtesy of Tyson Kirkby. Tyler Jurich, Kyle Powell had assists on that goal. That is it, but Binghamton, so many chances in period number one. Emil Strome had two of them, and the Black Bears holding on to a 1-0 lead. Binghamton outshot Danbury in that first frame, 13-7. We are going to take our first time out here on the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show, but when we return, we'll cue up the highlights of the first period. So stay with us. The Booster Club highlights coming up right after this from Binghamton on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
The Ross Park Zoo sits tucked into the northern face of Binghamton's South Mountain. The zoo officially opened in 1875 and is the fifth oldest zoo in the country. Come view over 100 different species. Are you planning your next event? Train rides, the children's zoo, Ross Park Carousel, Snack Shack, Gift Shop, and special education stations are just some of the reasons why Ross Park Zoo should be your next event. You can even set up wild encounters. Give Ross Park Zoo a call at 607-724-5461 or online at rosspark.zoo.org.
You could save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive, but when we just come out and say it, it feels like it falls a bit flat. So instead, we're going to have someone else say it. Because for some reason, when a random person talks about how great something is in a commercial, it's more believable.
I saved with a Progressive home and auto bundle.
And there you have it. I mean, I'm not sure why she's more believable than me, but either way, you get the point about the saving. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Discount not available in all states or situations.
Ideal Bowling Center, located at 119 Jennings Street in Endicott, has 38 amazing lanes of bowling, large video screens, and automatic scoring. But that's not all. Ideal Bowling Center has a newly remodeled bar with 6 televisions, billiards, darts, and quick draw to entertain you. Don't forget about Ideal Bowling Center's snack counter for your appetite and a pro shop for all your bowling needs. Ideal Bowling Center, 119 Jennings Street in Endicott. Or call 607-748-3546.
Get moving today with the Planet Fitness Black Card and check out all the perks, like access to over 2,000 locations, bring a guest anytime, plus massage chairs and so much more. With tons of space in our super clean clubs, your fitness is essential. Get all the perks with the PF Black Card. Commitment may apply. See club for details.
New hockey team in town means all new gear. Dress like the Black Bears and go online to blackbearshop.com. The all-new blackbearshop.com has t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, jerseys, and so much more. Do you want a custom jersey with your name and number? We can do that too. Stop by the merchandise stand at all Black Bears home games, or even come by the front office during office hours. Show your Binghamton hockey pride by visiting blackbearshop.com.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports intermission show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. After 20 minutes, it's the Black Bears, a 1-0 lead over the Danbury Hattricks. Time for the highlights of that first period, brought to you by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. And didn't take long, these two teams playing their fourth game in a row against one another. Steve Brown was suspended for yesterday's game, back in the lineup, and he didn't like Thomas Aldworth. Yates, toe drag, in front, right leg pad save made. Oh, and then, boy, boy, Brown is just swinging away at Aldworth. What on earth happened? Steve Brown, fresh off a suspension, goes after Aldworth. The puck was coming out the other way. Did not see how that started. Just saw the end of it. But my goodness, Brown is livid. So Brown went off on that one. It was a two-minute roughing penalty. Him and Aldworth would go at it a little bit later in period one. That resulted in a five-minute major and a game misconduct for Brown. Aldworth went off to the locker room with a two-minute minor penalty. We'll see if he returns in this game. Wasn't sure if he was injured on that or maybe a equipment issue. But we'll let you know when the teams come out for period two. Moving on in the first period, Emil Strome, probably the best chance of the year, maybe. That didn't go in. Almost, but not enough. Kyle Powell sets up. He's got Jurich to the right. Powell, Strome, oh my goodness, off the inside of the post, and it stays out. You got to be kidding. Here comes Ruiz the other way, and a glove save by Liskowitz. So Strome had that puck on the side of the net. DeSalvo was diving back to his right, and it was hard to tell whether that either A went just off the inside of the post, across the goal line and stayed out, or did DeSalvo get the end of the stick blade on that and keep it out? Maybe a little bit of both. Could have been post to stick and out. Either way, I thought it was an easy tap-in, and DeSalvo did a great job getting back across the crease, and that created a little urgency for Strome, and that kept the game scoreless on that missed opportunity. But Binghamton would get a power play later in period one, and Tyson Kirkby right after the missed opportunity by Strome. Kirkby backhander and gave Binghamton a 1-0 lead. It was hard to tell if DeSalvo got just a piece of it, or did that go off the inside of the post and right along the goal line. Kirkby So that goal by Kirkby, this is his second game with the Binghamton Black Bears. He scored last night in Danbury and gets one here tonight. So two goals in two games for Kirkby, and that is the only goal from period number one. Highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Join them. Just visit their table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game. We'll take another break. Out-of-town scoreboard coming up right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sports vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at ExciteMotorsports.com.
You're always up for some fun with the family, so you order the essentials, a new board game, some baking supplies, and even a new projector for outdoor movie night. And with the Bank of America customized cash rewards credit card, you can choose to earn 3% cash back on online shopping, which could increase to up to 5.25% as a preferred rewards member. Rewards which you can put toward an extra treat that everyone will enjoy, like an old-fashioned popcorn machine. Visit bankofamerica.com/more rewarding and apply now. Copyright 2021 Bank of America Corporation.
Trivium Packaging, a global leader in sustainable metal packaging with more than 60 locations worldwide, has immediate openings at its Conklin, New York facility. Trivium serves a diverse range of customers and is an essential part of the U.S. food supply chain. Trivium Packaging offers excellent compensation and benefits like these. Apply anytime at triviumpackaging.com/careers or scan the QR code on the screen. Trivium Packaging currently has openings for tool and die technician, mechanical technician, quality technician, and shipping and receiving technician.
Since 1939, Endwell Rug has been family-owned and operated with one goal in mind: complete customer satisfaction. Endwell Rug offers a full spectrum of the finest quality floor covering products, and they are the premier installer at Binghamton University. Endwell Rug was voted the Reader's Choice Award winner for Best Flooring Store in 2019 and in 2020. With two locations in Endwell and Oneonta, they're the best floor show in town. Endwell Rug at 607-748-7366.
CryoWorks helps you with cold therapy. Just like the ice the black bears skate on, CryoWorks uses freezing temperatures to create a healing process. In just minutes, cryotherapy helps reduce inflammation, improves muscle tissue recovery, and boosts your immune system. CryoWorks uses three different forms of therapy: whole body, local, and cryofacials. The Black Bears players trust CryoWorks, and so should you. Visit them at 26 South Washington Street, Binghamton, 607-269-5392. CryoWorks, wellness without medicine.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Quick check at the John Pauling State Farm out-of-town scoreboard early in the third. Port Huron and Carolina tied at one. And Watertown and Columbus, no score, 6:53 into period one. That's a look at the out-of-town scoreboard presented by John Pauling State Farm. Visit them online at paulininsurance.com or call 607-798-7191. That's it for the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show. Period two coming up next on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
EBE CMS Imaging Solutions is the official printer provider of the Binghamton Black Bears. For over 40 years, they've been serving businesses around the Southern Tier. Locally owned and operated, EBE CMS Imaging Solutions has a full line of authorized Canon, Sharp, and Kyocera products. With multifunction printers, copiers, and fax machines, they'll help you determine which product is best for your needs, and their staff provides fast and efficient service. EBE CMS Imaging Solutions, 607-723-00.
Rolando's Diner is now open. Rolando's Diner, a 50-year tradition in Binghamton, is now open. They are still located in the same place, 140 Court Street, and they still have the same great menu and same great prices. Daily and weekly specials available. They missed you and can't wait to see all of their happy customers again. Rolando's Diner, eat in or take out. Open 7 a.m. until 3 p.m. daily. Call 607-723-9058 for takeout. See you soon.
Are you looking to get your hands on game-worn autographed jerseys? You're in luck. Black Bears fans can now bid live online for game-worn jerseys. Just head to BinghamtonBlackBears.com and click Live Online Auctions on the homepage. You can even download the Live Source mobile app on any device, so you never miss a chance to place a bid. Live Online Auctions are going on now. Download the Live Source mobile app or visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
The area's premier fitness facility, Court Jester Athletic Club, is excited to be open and ready to serve you during your next workout. Join in a new and improved gym experience with fitness and safety top of mind. Updated cleaning and sanitation procedures will help keep you healthy and ready to keep pushing. Plus, utilize the newly renovated and remodeled equipment and exercise spaces. Reach your goals and escape your limits at Court Jester Athletic Club, a one-stop fitness experience.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Set to go, period number two here inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Rob Lopolis, welcome back. Black Bears with a 1-0 lead. Gino D'Angelo, Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz won the opening faceoff. Gino gets this one back, and period two is underway. Tyler Jurich lost the puck to Tal Finberg. D'Angelo regroups. Turns back into his own end. D'Angelo out of the reach of Tyler Jurich. 19:32 left to go in the second. And trying to see if Aldworth is on the bench down low. It's hard to tell as offside on Danbury. 37 seconds into period number two. Taking a look at the bench, trying to see if you could see Aldworth out there. The play is back underway. Emil Strom into the offensive zone. It's Strom, Ivashkin, Newberg. Newberg fires a puck into the far corner. Ivashkin takes it. Nikita Ivashkin, a backhander, trying to go through the legs of DeSalvo. And a save made with 19 minutes and 5 seconds left to go in the second period. Offensive zone faceoff inside the left wing circle. Shot by Turner from the left point. Blocker pad save made by DeSalvo. Turner, left circle, splits the D. Turner around another man, in, trying to wrap it around on the short side. Puck still loose, top of the crease, comes free. And Strome had it for just a second. And the puck cleared all the way down the ice. No icing, MJ Merkel first to it. Merkel up the wall for Ivashkin, it's in his skates. Nikita cross ice to Yates. Up for Newberg. Newberg hits the puck deep. Danny Vanderweel comes on. Gavin Yates out there. Ivashkin is off. Gavin Abbott comes on now. Abbott almost kept the puck inside the zone, and then it hit Gavin Yates, and a whistle on the offside with 18:08 left to go in period two. Face off in the neutral zone. Dmitry Daniluk up the left wing wall. Gets by Kyle Powell, but it touched him, so no icing. Fitzgerald spins away from the pressure. That was Brett Jackson. Fitzgerald takes the pass from Powell, then goes cross ice for Vanderweel. Vanderweel hit in front of the bench. Powell was stepping up on the play. And Colin Fitzgerald back in his own end. Fitzgerald back up the ice from left to right. Lost it, lost an edge. Daniluk takes over. Dmitry Daniluk will backhand all the way down. And this will be an icing with 17:28 remaining of the second period. The face-off in the offensive zone coming up. Wrapped in behind the net, Gino D'Angelo. In front of Jurich scores! Lead with 17:19 remaining in the second. What a look from below the goal line out front to Jurich. D'Angelo to Kirkby to Jurich.
Tyler Jurich. Assisted by number 95, Gino D'Angelo. And by number 15, Colin Fitzgerald. Time of the goal, 2:41. Jurich from D'Angelo and Fitzgerald. Time of the goal, 2:41.
Well, I must have saw that completely different. Apologize there, but nonetheless, Jurich makes it 2-0. 16:42 remaining in the second. Matthew Wallar behind the net. Big collision. Now to Jurich. Onto the backhand of Emil Strome. Strome in. Kuznetsov was stepping up. And now Newberg stepped up 2-on-1. Wallar trying to get back. He does. And a good job by Pekarski to Ivoskin. And now it turns into a 3-on-2. Ivoskin around the defense. Blocker pad save by DeSalvo. What a move by Nikita Ivoskin. Binghamton break out. Right inside the offensive zone. Backhand, save made. Sam Turner with the opportunity. And it's Corey Anderson. Anderson to Kodiak White Duck, him and MJ Merkel. Merkel runs into him below the goal line. Newberg goes down to the ice. Breakout pass for Ivoskin, but Dmitry Daniluk cut him off. Daniluk had to dodge a dump in from Corey Anderson. Almost hit him in the helmet. Saucer pass to Merkel. Merkel fires it up to Vanderweel. His pass out of the reach. And icing waved off. Collision. Stefanson hit by Gavin Abbott. MJ Merkel over to Abbott on the left wing wall. Rips the puck in deep. DeSalvo starts the breakout from behind his own net. And Merkel steps up at center, dumps it in, goes to the bench. Powell is on for him. 14:48 to go in the second. 2-0 Binghamton. Over the blue line into the offensive zone. Powell blocks the centering attempt. Knocked out of the air. Liskowitz with a good save. Gavin Yates ahead. He's got Abbott and Fitzgerald with him. Yates around Kuznetsov. Tries to go back to his left. Lost it. Now it's a 2-on-1 the other way. Finberg. Now Finberg and Kyle Powell blocks the pass. Now Danny Vanderweel over the blue line. Good pass. Vanderweel. Powell waits. Holds. Looking out front. Oh, boy. Nasty collision in front of the net. Between Vanderweel and Yates. Not sure if someone was pushed into the other person. Well, take a look when we return. 14:09 left to go in the second. 2-0 Binghamton. Back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Has this ever happened to you? My friend was telling me about his new pair of headphones, so I looked them up online. Now, everywhere I go is a creepy ad for those headphones I looked at one time. I hate that feeling like I'm being watched. I got DuckDuckGo and saw a difference right away. With one download, you can search and browse privately, avoiding trackers, all for free. It's that simple. Take back your privacy online with DuckDuckGo. Privacy simplified.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Lead for the Binghamton Black Bears. WWE is returning to Binghamton. Get ready for the Sunday Stunner, April 24th, right here at the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Roman Reigns defends the Intercontinental Championship against Drew McIntyre. Also, the SmackDown Tag Team Championship will be up for grabs as well. Tickets start at just $15. Available now at the Mirabito box office or Ticketmaster. Or you can go to Black Bears social media, Facebook and Instagram. We are giving away 4 tickets to WWE. Just head to the Instagram pages. You'll see the post and how you can participate. Back underway with 13:50 left to go. Side of the net, Ruiz jams. Pekarski runs into him, goes down to the ice, and then Liskowitz gets a cover and a whistle. We have 13 minutes and 47 seconds to go in period number 2. The Black Bears now have e-gift cards available. You can choose to look at the card, how much to put on it, and you can send it right through email. Can be used for tickets or merchandise. Black Bears e-gift cards available at BinghamtonBlackBears.com. Offensive zone face-off inside the left wing circle for Danbury. Kodiak White Duck, side of the net, backhand pass, blind backhand pass out to center from Phil Bronner. And that was pushed all the way down the ice. Defensive zone face-off for Binghamton in the right wing circle. Bronner behind the net. Colin Fitzgerald, wraparound chance. Stop with the left leg pad by Liskowitz. Tripping penalty coming up to Colin Fitzgerald. And Binghamton will be on the Trivium packaging penalty kill for the first time tonight. And Fitzgerald says, "What I do?" And he's going to head off. Tripping penalty. All penalties for Binghamton. Brought to you by Trivium Packaging. They are hiring. Apply online at triviumpackaging.com. I think Fitzy just got the stick of the skates down behind the net. Kuznetsov to Johnny Ruiz. Didn't get to the net. Ruiz fired it into his own teammate, Brett Jackson. Now to Kuznetsov. Jackson, side of the net, goes in down low below the goal line. Kuznetsov, bottom of the left circle to Ruiz. Back to Kuznetsov. His shot in and out of the glove of Liskowitz. Batted out of midair. Stayed out as well. Kuznetsov to Ruiz. Shot tipped wide. Trying to clear is Mathieu Boilard. Abbott tried to clear. He could not. Held in. Right circle. Cross ice. Scooped up off the wall by Kuznetsov. Up to Ruiz. Minute 17 to go in the Trivium packaging penalty kill. 2-0 Binghamton. Ruiz. Slap shot. Save. Rebound. Mathieu Boilard goes down onto his side and saves a goal. Out to the top of the right circle. Ruiz hammers one. Blocked by D'Angelo. Up and out of play. 12:26 to go in the second. Wide open net. The shot came in from Ruiz, and indeed, Boilard went down to his knees and kept that puck out. Great play behind the net. Kyle Powell intercepts, goes off the left wing boards, and sends the puck down the ice. 47 seconds now to go in the Colin Fitzgerald tripping penalty. 12:07 remaining in the second. Binghamton a 2-0 lead. Left side. Snapper scores. John McDonald. Power play goal. And Danbury's on the board with 12 minutes to go in the second. So many chances on that power play for Danbury. And they get one in. So the Black Bears lead is now one.
Assisted by number 27, Corey Anderson, and by number 7, Vinny Soucy. Top of the goal, 8 minutes even. McDonald from Anderson and Soucy. Top of the goal.
Back underway. Glove down by DeSilvo. The whistle with 11 minutes and 41 seconds left to go. In period number two. Face off, offensive zone, right wing circle. Right back into the offensive zone. Steered away. Now to the right point. Stefancic. Below the goal line, just outside the trapezoid. Now to the near wall. Juric trying to get it out. Kept in. Brett Jackson. Merkel pushes him. Merkel lost it. Jackson right circle. Centers. Picked off by Gino D'Angelo. D'Angelo wanted Juric. That's intercepted. Knocked out of the air by Tyson Kirkby. I do not see Thomas Aldworth. As Merkel locks up, and they're going to hug it out. With 10:45 remaining in the second. I don't even think those should be penalties. Yes. Little dancing around at the bottom of the circle. And they're going to put him in the box. Looked like a friendly hug to me. And apparently, Merkel's going to get the only penalty. He hugged too hard. With 10:45 to go in the second. Give him a little extra. How do you do? So Merkel off for a rough, and it's another trivia packaging penalty kill. ...10:40 remaining.
2 minutes for holding. Time of the penalty, 9:15.
Okay, holding. Shot tipped up and out of play with 10:32 to go in the second. And a minute 48 left to go with the Merkel holding penalty. Binghamton a 2-0 lead. Shots are 19-14 Black Bears. Ruiz. Oh boy, big save by Liskowitz. That was a sneaky shot from the right point by Zachary Lazaro. Right side. Brett Jackson, backhand, left leg pad save, and Gavin Abbott clears on the backhand. 10:09 remaining in the second, almost midway through this game here on a Saturday night. A 1:20 to go in the Merkel hold. Up the left side, Jackson. Right side, Johnny Ruiz. Onside, glove save by Liskowitz. With 9:56 remaining in period two. We'll take a timeout. The Black Bears holding on to a 2-1 lead. We're back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Hard-hitting action of Black Bears hockey returns Friday, April 1st and Saturday, April 2nd against Columbus at 7 p.m. Friday is College Rush Night. All college students get $5 tickets. Then Saturday is the Police versus Fire Hart Cup game for just $15. Watch Police versus Fire at 3:30 and stay for the Black Bears game at 7. $5 from every ticket will benefit the American Heart Association. For tickets, visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. The Black Bears getting out to a 2-0 lead here in the second, but Danbury answering back on a great shot from the left wing circle by John McDonald, his fourth of the season. Cleared to center, Vanderweel. Say that was offside with 9:47 to go in the second. The Black Bears have special online jersey auctions happening all season long. Just keep checking back at BinghamtonBlackBears.com to see current and upcoming ways you can get your hands on some game worn jerseys. Tonight's jersey auction is not online. It's in-house only between in section four immediately following tonight's game for your chance to own a Black Bears St. Patrick's Day themed jersey that they're wearing tonight. Down the left wing side, John McDonald to Corey Anderson, and the puck gets over the stick of McDonald and out to center. 9:19 to go in the second period, a 2-1 lead for Binghamton. Tyson Kirkby, Tyler Jurich, the goals for the Black Bears. John McDonald, the lone goal for Danbury. Two of the three goals here tonight on the power play. Kyle Powell tried a little toe drag into the offensive zone, lost the puck, and it's backhanded out to center. 8:54 to go in the second. Oh, nice drag by McDonald. Went to backhand the puck out to the front of the net. Still free. Liskowitz the save on the rebound as well. And he hangs on with 8:46 to go in the second. 2 seconds to go in the Trivium Packaging penalty kill. Our next broadcast coming up tomorrow afternoon on the road in Delaware. Join us for the Endwell Rug pregame show beginning at 2:45, and the puck drops at 3. Binghamton at Delaware tomorrow afternoon. It's our next broadcast right here on Fox Sports 1430. Binghamton off the faceoff. Stick save made, Liskowitz, and he gets the puck out to the neutral zone. Penalty is over, back to 5-on-5. Binghamton a 2-1 lead. Tyler Pekarski outside the trapezoid area. The trapezoid does not exist in the league though. D'Angelo, drop pass for Kirkby. Lost it. Up the right boards, Matthew Wallar, the shot saved by DeSalvo, and a whistle with 8:14 to go in the second. The draw, 8:05 to go in the second. Tyson Kirkby forced back in, down low, below the goal line. Still has the puck on the breakout to Tyler Jurich. Jurich, below the goal line. Backhands towards the front of the net. D'Angelo overskated it, and then elevated to center, gloved down by Matthew Wallar. Wallar. Good bounce to Gino D'Angelo. Right side to Jurich. Well, that might have been offside on Binghamton. Play continues. Hit by Kirkby on Tal Finberg. And now Gino D'Angelo. Boy, that puck hopped up. And now a goal! That took some sort of hop. Gino D'Angelo up front. Tyler Jurich is second of the game. 3-1 Black Bears with 7:21 to go in the second. That puck was fired in deep. And it went up in the air and rolled along the backboards. D'Angelo chased it down. And right out front, Jurich hammers it into an empty net.
There's goal! Scored by number 22, Tyler Jurich. Assisted by number 95, Gino D'Angelo. Time of the goal, 12:39. Jurich from D'Angelo, 12:39.
So Binghamton back out to a two-goal lead. Shots are 21-19 with 6:50 to go in the second. Ivashkin in a foot race. Good play by the goaltender, Peter DeSalvo. Newberg batted out of the air by Brett Jackson. Jackson can't get through Colin Fitzgerald. Ahead to Emil Strome. Stepping up on him was Zachary Lazaro. Newberg, a good hit. Powell went to center. Adamo Asselin down the left wing side. Hounded by Ivashkin, and then what was that? As Brett, or check that, Powell is going to grab a hold of him. And here we go. Powell not happy. Powell's got a hold of two guys. Brett Jackson just cut in front of it, looked like Nikita Ivashkin. And Ivashkin on one knee. As we see the aftermath of the scrum, Powell was heated. And Ivashkin will skate back to the bench, but honestly, it was really hard to tell. I thought incidental contact right away. The guys on the ice disagree. We get a replay of it here. And that was skate first. And Thomas Allworth is back on the ice. He got some stitches. It's a Big E Tire power play. Binghamton a 3-1 lead. Jurich over to Kyle Powell. Powell to Jurich. Back to Powell. Holds. Backhand right circle for Kirkby. Back to Powell. Powell tipped in front by Strome. What a nice play. At the center point, Danbury did a good job. They blocked the right pass to Kirkby, so then Powell just sent one to the front of the net that Emil Strome deflected right on net, and a great save. Right point Powell, just inside the blue line. Powell to Kirkby, down low to Gavin Yates, to Kirkby. Backhand up top to Powell. Powell waits. Danbury giving him the pass to Kirkby. Does so, right back to Powell. Side of the net. Evan Yates was right there. Tipped it just wide. Kirkby back up top to Powell. Back to Kirkby, right wing circle. Dishes down low to Gavin Yates. Yates to Powell. They're blocking the pass to Jurich. Powell now to the give and go. Out front for Strome. Sends it wide. Back for Strome again. He scores! Great work on the power play. And Emil Strome finally cashes in tonight. 14th of the season. And Binghamton out to a 4-1 lead with 5:06 to go in the second. That is free cheeseburgers for everyone.
Tyler Jurich. Time of the goal, 14:54. That's Strome from Kirkby and Jurich. time of the Burger King Burger goal. 14:54. Pick up your coupons, good.
So there you have it, the Burger King Burger goal, courtesy of Emil Strome. Shot from the right side, gloved by Liskowitz, and then Sam Turner. Great pass back to Strome. 4-1 lead, Binghamton. Crisscross. Ivashkin shoulder save by DeSalvo. 4:14 to go in the second. We'll take a timeout. Binghamton, a 4-1 lead over Danbury. Back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
New team, new website. Check out the all-new Binghamton Black Bears website, binghamtonblackbears.com. See all of the Black Bears' upcoming promotions, the latest news on your Black Bears. Check out up-to-the-second standings and stats, and save money with special offers. You can even listen to every broadcast and see what's been happening on their social media. Be sure to follow the Black Bears on social media as well. Stay up-to-date with everything Black Bears at www.binghamtonblackbears.com.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. 4:14 to go in the second, and Binghamton has a 4-1 lead. Emil Strome with the latest. Offensive zone faceoff inside the left wing circle. Binghamton, a 3-goal lead. Can they hang on to it? Offensive zone, good defensive play. Now to the left wing side, centered save, Liskowitz. Huge save by Owen Liskowitz. And here comes Aldworth. Aldworth out front off the skates of Danny Vanderweel. Aldworth stitched up, he's back out there. 3:37 left to go. Chance, Vanderweel, net off the pegs, and a whistle. With 3 minutes and 29 seconds to go in the second period. Face off in the offensive zone, right wing circle. Shots are 25-21 Binghamton. D to D pass to Fitzgerald, tipped just wide of the net. That was Gino D'Angelo cutting in front of the net, along with Tyson Kirkby. Kirkby below the goal line. Lazaro there, D'Angelo run into. And the snapshot tipped in front by Kirkby again. On the breakout, Adamo Asselin. Trying to go through the skates of Fitzgerald, and now Kyle Powell will just lift up and out to center. Johnny Ruiz takes over and fires a hammer shot from center ice, just missing. Powell to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald run into by Ruiz. Kirkby, good pass to Powell. Powell right side, dumps it into the far corner for Tyson Kirkby. Has it on his backhand, now to Gino D'Angelo. D'Angelo off the wall, picked off momentarily by Johnny Ruiz, and now back to center for Matthew Boilard. Boilard to Pekarski. Pekarski's pass intercepted by Tal Finberg. Here comes Finberg. Good stick by Pekarski. Now it's Kirkby, a little spinorama. Had momentum with Jurich, and he'll just backhand the puck in. 2:04 to go in the second. Binghamton a 4-1 lead here under Danbury. Corey Anderson, right wing side. Boilard, his pass, he wanted Ivashkin, had to get rid of it though pretty quick. Dmitry Daniluk takes over, then gives it right back to Boilard. Boilard to Newberg. Newberg to Strome. Strome, saucer, Pekarski, right by the head of Ivashkin and missed the net. Boilard hammers one, blocked by Dmitry Daniluk, and then Daniluk's outlet through the legs of Corey Anderson. And Pekarski runs, gets run into by Anderson, kept in down low. Corey Anderson, bottom of the left wing circle, shot. And boy, that went up in the air, and it stays out. Thought that might have snuck over the right leg pad, but a great save by Liskowitz. And a whistle with 1:17 to go in the second. The Learning Ladder Child Care Centers are located in Endicott and Johnson City. They enroll children ages 6 weeks to 12 years old. Call 607-770-3806 for an appointment today to walk through one of their facilities. Come join their family, and they will help your child grow. MJ Merkel. Just behind Thomas Aldworth. 1 minute, 4 seconds to go in period two.
1 minute to play in the period.
Blast, rebound front of the net, cleared away by Aldworth. Aldworth below the goal line, Merkel, and a penalty. And MJ Merkel will head back to the box with under a minute to go in the second period. Staying with us, we'll have the Excite Motorsports second period intermission show coming up. Full summary of the first 40 minutes and then highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. And we'll finish it off with the out-of-town scoreboard. Johnny Ruiz, now left side, Kuznetsov. Big penalty kill here for Binghamton late in the second. Kuznetsov, down low to Tal Finberg. Give and go with Finberg. As he was looking in front of the net. At Brett Jackson. And in the crease was Tal Finberg. And they blow the whistle. They're going to move it out to the neutral zone with 23.5 to go in the second. Penalty to Merkel. If Binghamton can hold Danbury off the board, that'll carry over to the final frame. 23 and a half left in the second. And the Black Bears a 4-1 lead. Face off in front of the Danbury bench. Far side, knocked into the offensive zone by John McDonald. 15 seconds to go. Powell, and the lead pass almost for Gavin Abbott. Johnny Ruiz, one last chance, lets it go, and a save made by Owen Liskowitz as time expires on period number two. So Binghamton, it built a 4-1 lead over Danbury. When we come back, we'll have tonight's Excite Motorsports second period intermission show. Shots are 25-23 Binghamton, and the score is 4-1 also Binghamton. We'll take a break, and when we return, Excite Motorsports second period intermission show right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Be the first to get all the latest Binghamton Black Bears news, special exclusive offers, and stay up to date on upcoming games by signing up to join the Binghamton Black Bears email club. Just head to binghamtonblackbears.com and sign up today. You'll receive team-related news delivered right to your inbox. Keep an eye out for special exclusive offers only available to email club members. It's the Binghamton Black Bears email club. Sign up and start saving money today.
Panera, you can say yes to both of your cravings. We call it You Pick Two. And with over 465 pairings, you'll find a meal sure to satisfy any mood. Are you feeling both fresh and fun? Pick our Fuji apple salad with a new Thai chicken soup. Or maybe you're feeling classic and bold. Pair some creamy mac and cheese with our new citrus Asian crunch salad. Pick your perfect pair and order a You Pick Two today. Panera, the familiar made fantastic.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
The Homer Men and Boys Store, a family-owned business providing clothing and footwear for the entire family since 1951. Located just 40 minutes north on Route 81 in the beautiful village of Homer. The Homer Men and Boys Store carries a huge inventory of name-brand products at discounted prices, like Carhartt, Red Wing, Carolina, Levi's, Columbia, North Face, Timberland, and many more. We carry all sizes from size 3 months up to 5X. We treat our customers like members of our family. If we don't have it, you don't need it. The Homer Men and Boys Store, located 40 miles north on Route 81. Take exit 12 and follow the signs to Homer, or see us on the web at homermensandboys.com.
When a hockey team ends up with six skaters and a goalie on the ice, it means somebody forgot to double check. And when you end up paying more for car insurance than you need to, it could also mean somebody forgot to double check. That's why State Farm will do a free discount double check by going through your policies to make sure you're getting all the discounts you deserve. Because those discounts could mean big league savings. It pays to double check. Call State Farm agent John Paulin in Johnson City today at 607-798-7191.
Two periods are complete. It's time for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. A recap of the first two periods, interviews, highlights, out-of-town scores, and more. Back up to the Planet Fitness broadcast booth for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report.
We are through two periods of play here inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, Binghamton. With a 4-1 lead over the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Again, time for the Excite Motorsports second period intermission report. Excite Motorsports, browse, ride, buy. Free next day delivery to New York NPA. Visit them online at excitemotorsports.com. Shots in that second period for the Binghamton Black Bears. Well, overall, the Black Bears 25 shots through two frames. And for Danbury, 23 shots on net. As Binghamton had a 1-0 lead after one. And we went to the second. Tyler Jurich would net two in period two. Gino D'Angelo assisting both of those. I got it wrong. I thought it was Kirkby with the assist on Jurich's first goal at 2:41 of the second. That gave Binghamton a 2-0 lead. And then John McDonald with a great shot exactly 8 minutes into the second. That was a power play goal. And Binghamton's lead was now 2-1. But two more goals later on in the second. Jurich is second of the game from D'Angelo at 12:39. Put Binghamton back out to a two-goal lead. And then Emil Strome from Tyson Kirkby and Jurich. Power play strike at 14:54. Strome was denied two massive chances earlier in the game. Finally gets one in. Power play goal. And Binghamton a 4-1 lead right now after two periods. Danbury out shooting Binghamton, though, in that second period. 16-12. But Binghamton, the 25-23 shot advantage so far through the entire game. Four penalties in the second period, three of them to Binghamton, two of them to MJ Merkel. Colin Fitzgerald went off at 6:35 for tripping, and then MJ Merkel a holding penalty as he got into it right on the goal line on the side of the net. And He sat for two. Then Brett Jackson at 13:52, tripping Miner. And then Merkel back in at 19:12 for high sticking. Merkel will be in the penalty box for the first minute and 13 seconds of the third period. And as a recap of the first two periods, we'll have the proof of that coming up right after this with the highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. We're back with more of the Excite Motorsports second period intermission show right after this on your home for Black Bears Hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Hi folks, Erwin Coe Sr. here from Big E Tire. It's our buy three, get one absolutely free sale. Oh, I know what you're saying. Wow, another tire sale. No, there's more. Listen, now when you buy three tires from Big E, you will get one tire absolutely free with free mounting, free lifetime balancing, free rotations, free 90-day road hazard warranty, free alignment check, free 30-day ride guarantee. Yeah, it's good, because the other guys charge you for everything. At Big E, everything is free. Interest-free financing for up to 12 months and the fastest air-free alignments in the Northeast. So call for details or just stop in. And thanks for the business.
For cars and trucks and tractors too, everything's right, so right for you. Best all around our Big E Tire and Auto Centers.
Big E Tire, I love those guys.
Since 1939, Enwell Rugg has been family-owned and operated with one goal in mind, complete customer satisfaction. Enwell Rugg offers a full spectrum of the finest quality floor covering products, and they are the premier installer at Binghamton University. Enwell Rugg was voted the Reader's Choice Award winner for Best Flooring Store in 2019 and in 2020. With two locations in Enwell and Oneonta, they're the best floor show in town. Enwell Rugg at 607-748-7366.
The Binghamton Black Bears are hitting the ice this season at Visions Federal Credit Union, Veterans Memorial Arena, and we want you to see all the hard-hitting action of Black Bears hockey all season long. That's why Visions members can get discounted tickets to every home game this season. It's one of the many reasons to join the Visions family today. To get your member discount and see the Black Bears in action, visit visionsfcu.org/events. Visions Federal Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA.
Get moving today with the Planet Fitness Black Card and check out all the perks, like access to over 2,000 locations, bring a guest anytime, plus massage chairs and so much more. With tons of space in our super clean clubs, your fitness is essential. Get all the perks with the PF Black Card. Commitment may apply. See club for details.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Time for the highlights of those first 40 minutes of play presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. All the way back in period one, Tyson Kirkby, the only goal, power play goal, got things started. It was hard to tell if DeSalvo got just a piece of it or did that go off the inside of the post and right along the goal line. Kirkby, backhand, he scores! Tyson Kirkby. Strikes first with 8:03 left in the first. So Binghamton, a 1-0 lead after one. We go to the second. Tyler Jurich, an early goal. 2-0 Black Bears.
Wrapped in behind the net, Gino D'Angelo.
In front, and Jurich scores! What a feed from Kirkby to Jurich. And the Black Bears have a 2-0 lead with 17-19 remaining in the second. It was D'Angelo to Jurich. Binghamton a 2-0 lead. Then Nikita Ivashkin denied on a breakaway. Good job by Pekarski to Ivashkin, and now it turns into a 3-on-2 Ivashkin around the defense. Blocker pad save by DeSalvo. What a move by Nikita Ivashkin. Then John McDonald, power play goal. Danbury striking. Leading in the second, Binghamton a 2-0 lead. Left side. Snapper scores. John McDonald, power play goal. And Danbury's on the board with 12 minutes to go in the second. So Binghamton's lead was 2-1, but Jurich again. Hit by Kirkby on Tal Finberg. And now Gino D'Angelo. Boy, that puck hopped up. And now a goal. That took some sort of hop. And Gino D'Angelo up front. Tyler Jurich is second of the game. 3-1 Black Bears with 7:21 to go in the second. So Binghamton back out to a 2-goal lead. And then Emil Strom, big goal on the power play. They're blocking the pass to Jurich. Powell now to the give and go. Out front for Strom. Sends it wide. Back for Strom again. He scores! Season and Binghamton out to a 4-1 lead with 5:06 to go in the second. Binghamton a 4-1 lead. The highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Join the Booster Club. Visit their table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game. We'll take a break. Out of town scores coming up next on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
The Ross Park Zoo sits tucked into the northern face of Binghamton's South Mountain. The zoo officially opened in 1875 and is the fifth oldest zoo in the country. Come view over 100 different species. Are you planning your next event? Train rides, the Children's Zoo, Ross Park Carousel, Snack Shack, Gift Shop, and special education stations are just some of the reasons why Ross Park Zoo should be your next event. You can even set up wild encounters. Give Ross Park Zoo a call at 607-724-5461 or online at rosspark.zoo.org.
On the podcast, What Happened to Sandy Beal, journalist Melissa Jeltson investigates the death of a young woman who dreamed of a career in law enforcement, revealing a troubling pattern by officials close to the case.
I didn't take any of that crap because I could tell that they were hiding something.
Listen to What Happened to Sandy Beal on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts. Brought to you by DuckDuckGo. Protect your privacy online for free with DuckDuckGo.
New hockey team in town means all new gear. Dress like the Black Bears and go online to blackbearshop.com. The all-new blackbearshop.com has t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, jerseys, and so much more. Do you want a custom jersey with your name and number? We can do that too. Stop by the merchandise stand at all Black Bears home games, or even come by the front office during office hours. Show your Binghamton hockey pride by visiting blackbearshop.com.
Check out a Binghamton Black Bears game like you've never seen before with a Skybox night or group night. You can even watch warm-ups from the Black Bears bench with your friends, high-five the players as they take the ice, and so much more. Or watch the game in style in a Skybox and check out a new and improved food and drink menu. Call the Black Bears at 607-722-7367 and begin your group or Skybox experience.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sports vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at ExciteMotorsports.com.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside one final time. Quick check at the out-of-town scoreboard. In overtime, Port Huron has defeated Carolina 3-2. And down in Columbus, it was no score between Watertown and Columbus. Now Watertown has a 1-0 lead midway through the second. We'll take a break when we come back. Period three right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Ideal Bowling Center, located at 119 Jennings Street in Endicott, has 38 amazing lanes of bowling, large video screens, and automatic scoring. But that's not all. Ideal Bowling Center has a newly remodeled bar with 6 televisions, billiards, darts, and quick draw to entertain you. Don't forget about Ideal Bowling Center's snack counter for your appetite and a pro shop for all your bowling needs. Ideal Bowling Center, 119 Jennings Street in Endicott, or call 607-748-3546.
EBE CMS Imaging Solutions is the official printer provider of the Binghamton Black Bears. For over 40 years, they've been serving businesses around the Southern Tier. Locally owned and operated, EBE CMS Imaging Solutions has a full line of authorized Canon, Sharp, and Kyocera products. With multifunction printers, copiers, and fax machines, they'll help you determine which product is best for your needs, and their staff provides fast and efficient service. EBE CMS Imaging Solutions, 607-723-0000.
Hard-hitting action of Black Bears hockey returns Friday, April 1st and Saturday, April 2nd against Columbus at 7 p.m. Friday is College Rush Night. All college students get $5 tickets. Then Saturday is the Police versus Fire Hart Cup game for just $15. Watch Police versus Fire at 3:30 and stay for the Black Bears game at 7. $5 from every ticket will benefit the American Heart Association. For tickets, visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
CryoWorks helps you with cold therapy. Just like the ice the Black Bears skate on, CryoWorks uses freezing temperatures to create a healing process. In just minutes, cryotherapy helps reduce inflammation, improves muscle tissue recovery, and boosts your immune system. CryoWorks uses three different forms of therapy, whole body, local, and cryofacials. The Black Bears players trust CryoWorks, and so should you. Visit them at 26 South Washington Street, Binghamton, 607-269-5392. CryoWorks, wellness without medicine.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Period three set to get underway. Gino D'Angelo, Corey Anderson on the faceoff. Anderson wins it back. And period number three is underway. Tonight's third period presented by American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. They are built to a higher standard. Quick whistle, just 11 seconds in. And off the faceoff, they'll try it again. So two quick whistles, still a minute one to go in the MJ Merkel penalty for high sticking. Out to the point, Zachary Lazaro. Dmitry Kuznetsov to Lazaro. Ruiz somewhat fanning on the shot, but Corey Anderson gets it back. Anderson, good move. Lazaro, Ruiz scores. What a blast by Johnny Ruiz. Power play goal, and it's 4-2. Binghamton with 19:29 to go in the third. Got a good handful of Danbury fans here in attendance in Binghamton. Maybe checking out the game here for the first time. Not sure if they would have back in the UHL with the BC Icemen, but if they have, it's been a while. 19:10 left to go in the third period. Binghamton's lead now 4-2.
Ruiz, assisted by number 55, Zachary Lazaro, and by number 27, Corey Anderson. Reese from Lazaro and Anderson. Time of the power play goal, 31 seconds.
Gino D'Angelo back into the offensive zone. Finds Jurich. And a great save by Peter DeSalvo. Colin Fitzgerald off the right wing wall. Gives it up. And a long range wrister by Brett Jackson. Gloved down by Liskowitz. Leaves it for Tyson Kirkby, who drops the puck back for Kyle Powell. He's got to play it, though, Kirkby does, in the offensive zone. He was trying to come off the ice for a line change. Powell hit him with a pass. This will be icing on Danbury with 18:19 left to go in the third period. A 4-2 lead for Binghamton. An early goal, though, Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz just setting up on that left side. Ivashkin wrap around, save made by DeSalvo. Merkel's got it back up out to center ice. Over to Sam Turner. Turner onto the stick of Emil Strome. Strome one on four. Puck is dropped back, and now Ruiz back through center ice. Drops it. Tal Finberg a shot, and that goes way up in the air off the netting and comes back onto the ice. So the whistle blows with 17:45 to go in the third period. Two goal lead for Binghamton. They have a three shot advantage as well, 27-24. Johnny Ruiz just sets up in that left wing circle as Thomas Aldworth gets the puck into the offensive zone. Gavin Yates, drop pass for Powell, out for Aldworth, blast, partially blocked by Corey Anderson. He goes down to the ice as he took a wicked slap shot. Now a chance, a shot off the iron. Oh, that was a great shot by Phil Bronner. Off the outside of the post, and the puck went out of play. That would have made it a one-goal game early in the third period. Face-off in Binghamton's defensive zone left circle. Kicked ahead by Danny Vanderweel to Thomas Aldworth. Aldworth blows by the defense, and a left leg pad saved by DeSalvo. Colin Fitzgerald to Kyle Powell. Powell lost the puck to Brett Jackson, and now Colin Fitzgerald being chased down behind the net by Mike Lopez. Vanderweel, left wall, to Gavin Yates. Yates, Aldworth, and the puck skipped on him. 16:27 to go in the third period. We're live inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in Binghamton. Black Bears 4 and Danbury 2. Gavin Yates. Yates avoids the stick of DeSalvo. Up to Pekarski. Blocked by Johnny Ruiz. And his stick splits in half. Ruiz drops it. Goes back to the bench. Pekarski saved DeSalvo. And a whistle with 15:58 left to go in the third. Another reminder, the Black Bears back home Friday, April 1st, $5 college student tickets. Saturday, April 2nd, the Binghamton Police and Binghamton Fire Hart Cup game at 3:30. And then the Black Bears game at 7. $15 ticket gets you into both games, and $5 will go right to the American Heart Association. And then the Sunday game,
If you're a Wise Shoppers Card Club member, you get an $8 ticket. Must bring that card into the office or the Morabito box office here at the arena. So a lot going on here in a couple weekends from now. 15-27 to go in the third. Kirk B to Jurich for the hat trick save. Backhand by Kirk B. Another save by DeSalvo. Puck is cleared up and out to center ice. Onto the stick of Sam Turner. Turner gives it up, but cleared right back down the ice. Josh Newberg out there. Ooh, nice move by Turner. Good cutback and a good backhand over to Newberg. Jurich goes off the wall on the right wing side. Taken back by Kyle Powell. Swung into the zone. Long pass, far blue line. Fitzgerald trying to get back. What a save! How did Liskowitz keep it out? Was that his right leg pad? Or did he swing the stick up in the air? Emil Strom back the other way. Ivashkin in, draws a penalty. Oh, what a job by Owen Liskowitz. We'll take a break. 14:31 left to go in the third period. A 4-2 lead for the Black Bears on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Trivium Packaging, a global leader in sustainable metal packaging with more than 60 locations worldwide, has immediate openings at its Conklin, New York facility. Trivium serves a diverse range of customers and is an essential part of the U.S. food supply chain. Trivium Packaging offers excellent compensation and benefits like these. Apply anytime at triviumpackaging.com/careers or scan the QR code on the screen. Trivium Packaging currently has openings for tool and die technician, mechanical technician, quality technician, and shipping and receiving technician.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
So penalty coming up. And the Black Bears are on the Big E Tire power play. But what a chance at one end of the ice. Liskowitz somehow kept that out. And Zachary Lazaro is off on the effort by Nikita Ivashkin. Liskowitz will backhand to Jurich. Jurich wraps the puck back in deep for Kyle Powell. Powell gets away from Ruiz. Now to Aldworth. Aldworth holds onto the puck and drops it right back to Tal Finberg, almost like Finberg called for it. Finberg winds, fires, save made, Liskowitz. 13:55 to go in the third. A minute 23 left in the Big E Tire power play, but Kirkby was offside. And a whistle. If you or someone you know is celebrating a birthday, give the Black Bears a call and set up your birthday package. It includes a Black Bears custom birthday cake courtesy of Wegmans. 607-722-7367. Neutral zone face-off pulled back to Danny Vanderweel with a minute 15 remaining in the man advantage presented by Big E Tire. 13:40 to go, third period. The stick and glove of Corey Anderson went flying in the air. Sam Turner drops it back for Ivashkin, and now the Black Bears got to hustle back. The pass is just out of the reach of Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz, he draws a penalty, and Sam Turner's livid. Smart play by Ruiz, go in hard to the corner. He spilled down to the ice. Oh, wow. As Turner will skate to the box and will skate 4-on-4 for 50 seconds.
Number 20, Sam Turner, 2 minutes for hooking, time of the penalty, 6:40. Turner, 2 minutes for hooking, time of the penalty, 6:40.
The minute you feel that stick pinch or in your armpit, you can get that call. Kirkby behind the net. So 4-on-4, ice open up a bit for the next 23 seconds, and then Danbury will go on the power play and Binghamton will be on the Trivium Packaging penalty kill. 12 minutes, 42 seconds to go in the third. Binghamton going to try to hold on to possession until the penalty kill starts. That'll allow them to ice it. There's three to go in the penalty. Here's Fitzgerald and now Kyle Powell. So the Black Bears can try to burn some time. And good job by Tyson Kirkby. He comes off and a three-player change. Vanderweel, Pekarski, and Newberg are on with Powell. Under a minute to go in the Trivium Packaging penalty kill. Dmitry Kuznetsov, his team down two. Wrist shot deflected into the corner. Ooh, and then a huge hit as Pekarski slides hard into the boards. He gets right back up though. Play continues. 36 to go. A shot by Zachary Lazaro sends it high. 30 seconds remaining. And Newberg will clear. That was a hard hit. It was a legal hit, though. Fans wanted a penalty. I thought it was clean. It was just a hard hit, and Pekarski went sliding hard into the boards. He got right back up, though. Shot by Corey Anderson. He was knocked onto the ice by Danny Vanderweel. Shot by Anderson, side of the net. Another chance off the boards. Ooh, now we have a player injured for Binghamton. That's Vanderweel. He gets up. Here's Altworth. Check that. Turner, a shot and a shoulder save made by DeSalvo. Back to even strength. Merkel! They're going to call it, and someone's going to come in. Oh, he takes another guy down. Oh my goodness! Oh boy, Merkel. The hit at center ice. Tal Finberg is injured on the play. The puck came up to Finberg at center. Merkel stepped up and they're going to call it and they're going to send him out of the game, I believe. And now you hope Finberg's okay. He's going to get up. Towel to his nose. And Merkel is to the locker room. Well, I'm sure we'll get a look. Good to see Finberg skate off. The puck was well by Finberg, so an interference call at least. And they're going to talk it over. And boy, it's a huge decision. Two-goal game. A split-second decision to step up on the play by MJ Merkel. He was committed to it. And then after that, I forget who it was that went after Merkel, and he also ended up on the bottom end, but Finberg. Was down on the ice, able to get up. And you're glad to see that he was okay. As there was blood, and they're going to call a 5-minute major. It's a little zoomed out on the play. It's hard to see, but then after the fact as well. So a big moment for Binghamton in the penalty kill. As MJ Merkel giving a 5-minute major for the neutral zone hit, and Gavin Abbott's going to come over to serve the penalty. And it's another Trivium Packaging penalty kill. Aldworth is going to serve it. That'll allow Gavin Abbott to be on the penalty kill now. I like that move. And then I thought we were going to look at the after the fact, but nonetheless, it is a penalty kill for Binghamton.
Penalty to number 40, MJ Merkel. 5 minutes for head contact and a match penalty. Time of the penalties, 9:02. Merkel, 5 minutes for head contact and a match penalty. Time of the penalties, 9:02. Being served by number 19, Thomas Aldworth.
So there you have it, the head contact. And then shown to the locker room, 4:33. It is a major penalty. Binghamton is up 2, but now Danbury can score as many times as they want, as it's a major penalty. Johnny Ruiz behind the net centers, and Matthew Boilard ahead to Gavin Abbott. They're going to try to burn some time. Boilard forces the pass up the left wing side. Now to the blue line. Phil Bronner to Dmitry Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov, left wing circle. Blocked by Matthew Boilard. And then Gavin Abbott trying to get the puck out of the zone. A couple slashes with Vinny Susi. Pass up to the left point. Zachary Lazaro, top of the left wing circle. Now Lazaro again, tipped wide by Abbott. Great job by him. Well, Bronner, right on the goal line. Bronner looking down low. Cross ice through the crease, gets by Lazaro and out to center. 3:20 to go in the Merkel major penalty. For head contact. Inside the neutral zone on Tal Finberg. Left wing circle, Kyle Powell takes the puck in behind his net. And Finberg is right back out on the ice here on the power play for Danbury. So good to see him okay. He took a huge hit inside the neutral zone. The puck had already gone through his skates and then head contact. And that was the big call on Merkel. Out to the left point. John McDonald. And cleared. 2:27 to go in the Trivium Packaging penalty kill. Binghamton up 4-2. Now Powell. He will send the puck all the way down. And Kuznetsov in behind the net. It's Yates, Kirkby, Powell, and Sam Turner. Kuznetsov, toe drag, shot wide of the net. Yates could not get over to the puck in time. Saucer to the point for Corey Anderson. Gets the return pass, goes through him. Anderson finds it along the wall. Corey Anderson to Johnny Ruiz, and backhanded down by Tyson Kirkby. 7:40 to go in the third period. 1:40 remaining in the Merkel 5-minute major. Ruiz with a hammer. Blockered away to the right side by Liskowitz and then cleared by Tyler Pekarski. Gino D'Angelo is on. Gavin Abbott is on. with Pekarski and Mathieu Wallard. 7:17 to go, third period, a minute 18 to go on the Merkle penalty. Johnny Ruiz now to Tyler Pekarski. Pekarski along the wall with Kuznetsov, burning more time. Kuznetsov to the point, Lazaro. Anderson, shot, that stop. Ruiz whacks it. That went off the outside of the post. Kuznetsov takes it. Kuznetsov pushed down to the ice. The puck is underneath him. Wallard standing over him. And Pekarski can't get it out. Kept in by Ruiz. Pekarski didn't realize. And Gino D'Angelo trying to eat more time and get the puck out. Glove down left point. 30 seconds to go in the power play for Danbury. They trail Binghamton by two, and Gino D'Angelo will clear. 20 seconds left in the power play for Danbury. 6:14 remaining in the third period. The Black Bears with a 4-2 lead. One last chance. 10 to go in the power play. Here's Tal Finberg. He was injured. Now down low behind the net. Finberg lost it. Out of the box is Thomas Aldworth. Fans feeling it. Cross ice. Powell to Thomas Aldworth. Around the defense. Put down. Penalty shot for Thomas Aldworth. It is a penalty shot. And this place ready to explode. Aldworth got around Finberg. And we'll say it interrupted the shot the most. Here comes Thomas Aldworth. Cuts to his left, picks up some speed. Aldworth misses the net to give Binghamton a 5-2 lead. The score remains 4-2, and we'll take a timeout. 5:44 to go in the third period. A wild one in Binghamton. We're back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side with four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sports vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra.
Jersey.
Family of dealerships. Every vehicle at every location is priced to move. The wait is over. This is your chance to make the buy of the year. McGuireCars.com.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
4-2 lead for Binghamton with 5:44 to go in regulation. Offensive zone faceoff, huge penalty kill by the Black Bears. And then Thomas Aldworth hauled down, wraparound chance by Jurich, stopped with the left leg pad by DeSalvo. Aldworth was denied on the penalty shot. Gino D'Angelo near side. D'Angelo back in behind the net. Brings the puck up and lost it. But Colin Fitzgerald was right there. Backhanded by Jurich. Glove down by Kirkby. Kirkby to D'Angelo. Reaching for the puck. Came off the end of his stick. John McDonald. D to D pass to Dmitry Daniluk. 5 minutes to go in the third period. Colin Fitzgerald over to Kyle Powell. Powell waits behind the net. Kuznetsov waiting at the top of the crease. Powell leaves it for Emil Strom, who's got speed. Strom cut off by Finberg at center. Strom down the right wing side. pinned as he's in a battle with Daniluk. Kuznetsov taken back by Newberg. Newberg, Powell, tip in front of the net just over the crossbar. Kuznetsov on the breakout. Saucer knocked out of the air by Nikita Ivashkin, and Newberg will clear. 4:10 to go in the third. Binghamton up 4-2 on Danbury. Ballar, Ivashkin stopped in front of the net. Kodiak White Duck goes off the boards. Matthew Ballard takes over to Pekarski. Pekarski to Strome. Strome lost it. Ballard swings over to Pekarski. Pekarski at center. Knocked out of the air. Three minutes and 37 seconds. Here's Kodiak White Duck, stopped in front of the net. Not sure if Newberg got that or Liskowitz. Ivashkin, left wing side, in behind the net now. Cut off by Zachary Lazaro from his knees. Ivashkin tried to connect in front of the net. There's a piece of an equipment in front of the visiting net, and the long wrister stopped by Liskowitz, and we'll take our final break. 3 minutes, 14 seconds left to go in the third period. Binghamton a 4-2 lead. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
The area's premier fitness facility, Court Jester Athletic Club, is excited to be open and ready to serve you during your next workout. Join in a new and improved gym experience with fitness and safety top of mind. Updated cleaning and sanitation procedures will help keep you healthy and ready to keep pushing. Plus, utilize the newly renovated and remodeled equipment and exercise spaces. Reach your goals and escape your limits at Court Jester Athletic Club. A one-stop fitness experience.
Don't miss our biggest sale of the year. Move Metal in March is on at the McGuire family of dealerships. Every vehicle at every location is priced to move. The wait is over. This is your chance to make the buy of the year. McGuireCars.com.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
3:14 to go. Third period. On the breakout, it's Gavin Yates. Yates at center, goes to the right wing side for Thomas Aldworth. Aldworth, wrister, glove save, in and out of the glove. A DeSalvo for Turner, puck hops up and out to center. Now Turner, Kyle Powell. Powell over the blue line, 2:43 to go. Powell behind the net, out for Gavin Yates, and it's kept in right on the blue line by Sam Turner. Powell backs up out to center to play some defense. Vanderweel is back to help out as well. Inside the circle, a penalty coming up again to Binghamton. And Vanderweel, no argument, he'll head right to the box with 2:24 to go in the third period. So does Danbury, if you're Danbury, do you pull the goalie now? You got the power play. If you pull the goalie, you got a two-man advantage. But if you pull the goalie, Binghamton can now clear the puck all the way down the ice. And they can just take open shots at that net here late in regulation. They're going to leave DeSalvo in the net and bank on the power play goal with just one extra man, and Ballar will clear. 2:10 to go in the third period. Danny Vanderweel off. Great work down low, but just got the stick in there. Here comes DeSalvo to the bench. Extra skater is on. The extra skater's Brett Jackson. Wrist shot blocked by Gavin Abbott. And now Matthew Ballar will clear. No icing because Binghamton's on the Trivium Packaging penalty kill. 1:42 now to go in the third period. on the breakout. It's Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov over the blue line. One on two. Wrist shot tipped high. And then Boilard hit by Anderson. Boilard gave him a shot back. But Binghamton more concerned about just clearing the puck. They do so again. 1:23 to go in the third period. 4-2 Black Bears. Down the left wing side. Snapshot deflected up and out of play. John McDonald with a wrister. 1:15 to go in the third. And a timeout has been called. And it's going to get loud here in just a second with Sweet Caroline. Here, and that means Stop DWI wants to remind you to always have a plan when going out. Impaired driving has serious consequences and can impact your family, your job, and your community. If you're going out, please remember to have a plan. Download the I Have a Plan app for more information. .15 to go, third period, net still empty. 6-on-4. Danbury, just like Binghamton last night, they need two. Corey Anderson on the faceoff against Josh Newberg. In below the goal line to Anderson. Anderson right on the goal line. Out to the right point. 1 minute to go in the third. Ruiz, backdoor, Anderson scores. It is a one-goal game with 57 seconds to go in regulation. Great work. Anderson, a tap-in goal. And hold the phone. In the goal, and they're gonna just hold the clock for a second. So a 4-3 lead. Here comes DeSalvo to the net, or to the bench. Kyle Powell for the empty netter. That was tipped wide. That should not be an icing. That was tipped at center ice as Powell shot it out of the zone. It went off a glove up in the air. We'll see if they get together and talk about it. That was clearly tipped off the stick of Powell, and everyone missed it. It's going to stay in the defensive zone. That is a massive call. That's a huge call. D'Angelo, face-off one back to Ruiz. In front of the net, save, two saves, and held on to by Liskowitz. Now the face-off in the defensive zone. Left wing circle. D'Angelo back to the point. One-timer Ruiz and a glove save Liskowitz. Can the Black Bears get the puck out of the zone? They'll move the draw to the Binghamton defensive zone right wing circle. Anderson trying to get the puck out of the zone is Kirkby. Loose in front of the net. Covered by Liskowitz. Anderson was right there. He fanned on it. The puck was hopping. The Black Bears have let Anderson get wide open in front of the net. Right after the pass to faceoffs. They'll move it to the right wing circle. Jurich trying to pull it back. It's up top. 20 seconds to go. Side of the crease. Cleared into the corner. Can Binghamton get it out? They do. Not all the way. And here's Sam Turner. Turner. Kirkby. No penalty. Brings it to the corner. 4 seconds to go. Out to the neutral zone. That is it. The Black Bears hang on. What a remarkable final couple of minutes. A 4-3 victory for the Black Bears over Danbury. And Binghamton able to celebrate after the game. Those final minutes, it all began. Kyle Powell cleared the puck. He was going for the empty net. It went off a glove of a Danbury player and down the ice wide of the net. It was still called an icing. And then Danbury with huge chances after that. The Black Bears could not get the puck out of the zone. And Binghamton, a great win here on home ice in front of a great crowd of over 3,000. They're feeling it as well. We will take a break. When we return, the La Quinta Inn and Suites postgame show coming up right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Trusted Planet Pre-Owned for years as the local dealer for reliable, high-quality used vehicles at great prices. Trust that you will never pay more for your next car, truck, or SUV with the power of Matthews Auto behind you. At Planet Pre-Owned, we've got a huge selection available right now, and you never have to haggle to get our best price. Plus, we have financing options for everyone, from perfect credit to not-so-perfect credit and everything in between. Looking to sell your vehicle? We want to buy your car, even if you don't buy from us. Planet Pre-Owned on the Parkway with no hassle, no haggle, stress-free car buying, and over 500 high-quality cars, trucks, and SUVs available to choose from. Shop us online or on the Vesto Parkway across from A&W.
Planet Pre-Owned, more every day, everywhere.
Don't wait to put an end to junk sleep at Mattress Firm. Shop Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America, and get a good towards sleep accessories. Thanks to our highly trained sleep experts, Mattress Firm is the number one Tempur-Pedic retailer. With 200 hours of training, you can rest assured we'll find the perfect bed for you at the best price. In stock for immediate delivery with a low price guarantee. Unjunk your sleep only at Mattress Firm. Restrictions apply. See store for details.
You're always up for some fun with the family, so you order the essentials, a new board game, some baking supplies, and even a new